Well, that's because Kevin Benavides ended up having an absolute stormer. The 2021 runner recovered over 23 minutes after stopping with Falconer. That catapulted him to the top of the stage standings and put him right back in the mix for a second Dakar title. Remember, Kevin and Toby will be the last two bikers off the start line tomorrow as they set off in reverse order of overall ranking. It's going to be an absolute thriller. Well, as promised, Kevin went full gas to win his first stage of this edition. He's been in the top 10 every single day. Quintanilla, Sherena and Branch landed out the top 10. 12 measly seconds. There has never been a smaller gap going into the final day of the Dakar. So which of the two KTM riders will come out on top? And which of them will take a big step towards becoming the next World Rally Road champion? We'll find out on Sunday.
Marcelo Medeiros got lost before the first checkpoint, but despite losing 3 or 4 minutes, still made it 4 wins on the spin. Not since Nicola Calayasso in 2019 had a quad achieved that feat. Now joint 5th alongside Giroux and Capetti for most stage wins, and 8th for the blazing fast Brazilian. The same top 3, 2 stages in a row. After 4 in a row, Medeiros will be gunning for a 5-star end to Dakar 2023. Giroux now just has to get his Yamaha from start to finish, then he can celebrate being only the 3rd man to win the title more than once.
And let's watch a masterclass from 9-time World Rally Champion Sebastian Loeb. Yes, it might have been a different story had Sainz and Peter Hansel still been in the game and the gap to Nasser a little smaller, but the record books will show this is 6 stage wins in a row, and that's never been done on the Dakar before. And he's dominated in the week of the empty quarter, the dunes particularly soft today. He also has 7 total stage wins, and the ProDrive Hunter, a biofueled prototype don't forget, has 8 wins this Dakar.
Ouais, je suis bien dans le sable, ouais. C'est vrai.
Yeah, it's true. We managed to find a good rhythm, full of confidence. I was driving aggressively without mistakes or problems.
En faisant gaffe aux endroits cassés, la voiture est bien.
Yeah, it's cool.
Le moteur répond bien, et donc c'est cool, ouais.
6 in a row, Loeb has become king of the empty quarter, and it's a win by 5.5 minutes from Alatia with Ekstrom in 3rd. 5 Toyotas in the top 10, and crucially, the one in first place is on target for the Dakar 2023 win for Nasser Alatia. And it's clearly on Nasser's mind to keep one eye on the daily points in the defence of his World Rally Raid title.
Knowing he can't win the rally mid-January, can afford to push for the win daily, and with high risk comes exciting reward. Gasly clinched another win today. He was 50 seconds quicker than Ignacio Casale. It's a 5th stage victory for mid-Gasly, who is determined to leave Saudi on a high. Austin Jones can already taste the rally win. He's 54 minutes and 30 seconds ahead of Seb Quintero, with Demebius 3rd. And what a way as well for AJ to begin his first T3 season in W2RC.
This time, pain for Eric Gutschall. Yet the remarkable rookie turned it into a 3-minute gain. A big bump on kilometre 30 did damage, but not to his title hopes. A fantastic 4th stage win and breathing down Rockus's neck, the teenager willing to push through the pain barrier.
I think I gave the stage all I had in my heart. It was difficult for me. On kilometre 30 we really hit a big bump. I think I did something to my left hand, so it was the first stage in my life I drove with one hand. Completely, I don't know what happened to my fingers, but I did all my best and did everything I could.
Gutschall have won 7 of the 2023 stages, Eric with 4 of them alone, Pachuska and Zeidan making up the penultimate podium. Despite that, Rockus with just over 3 minutes to protect, but the Gutschall family will do all they can to help Eric take the crown.